Hey guys, we're gonna do a little bit of a full body yin. So start standing up. I'm gonna be at the front of your mat, feet are as wide as your mat. And then from here, slowly just coming into a forward fold, letting those arms hang. You want just a slight bend in the knees, so no legs locked out. Just a little micro bend there. Let the crown of the head hang, let the arms hang, just let everything relax. Try and bring the weights mostly towards the front of your feet. Like you can grab arms to elbows. Continue just hanging out here. Maybe you sway from side to side. Entirely up to you and how you feel. Just hold the longer here. Those hands dropped. I want you to go ahead and drop yourself into the bottom of a squat. Elbows inside those knees, palms together, pressing out. Sitting that chest nice and tall. From here, I'm going to walk those hands out a very few times. Say this, lift that upper back round out, tucking chin to spine, still trying to actively press those knees out towards the side as you let that torso drop in between them. A little bit longer here. Slowly roll on the back, sitting down. Sitting both those legs out in front, you're gonna tuck right foot in, to that inner thigh, right? From here, think of pointing right shoulder towards the left pinky toe, just kind of center yourself over that leg. And then big inhale, think about lengthening the spine. And exhale, hinge from the hip first, so keep that back as flat as you can till you can't go any further. Then from there, slowly allow that back to round out as you grab onto your foot. Be here for just a few minutes, right? So try your hardest to relax into it. Don't force anything. Back out of it a little bit, and then as the muscles start to loosen up, then slowly a little lower if you can. If you have a block or a pill or a blanket at home, you can always place it on top of your leg if your head is just not quite there, and relax your head onto that so you can kind of focus more so on the back side of your leg. A little bit longer here. Gently sit up. Now we're just going to switch. So go ahead and extend that right leg back out. You're going to tuck left foot to that inner right thigh. Same thing, sitting nice and tall, pointing left shoulder towards right pinky toe. Big inhale, lengthen the spine here. On that exhale, hinging from the hips first, keeping that back as flat as you can until you can't reach any further. Then from there, slowly roll it out, reaching for that right foot. Or don't really force it in the beginning. Slowly allow those muscles to relax as you get deeper into the posture. no longer here. Gently extend that left leg out. Just pitter-patter those legs out. All right, from here, you're gonna take the top of that right foot just to the outside of your hip. That foot should be pointing straight back. You can move that calf out of the way. Now, if you feel like you're just being pushed over to the left way too much, you can take a block, blanket, whatever you may have, and stick it underneath your left hip. Kind of help elevate you, but that foot should be pointing straight back, no bent ankles, you're not sitting on it. And then this is one that you want to allow that muscle to relax a little bit. I know this is a very awkward position for most, but try not to tense up, relax as much as you can. Lean it back, maybe you just start here, and then from there you can slowly work your way back a little bit more. A little bit longer here. Very gently bring it up. I'm gonna take that hand just to the top of the ankle. Gently bringing that heel out in front, grab the bottom of your foot for a counter stretch of that ankle. extending that leg out, rub out that knee, do some ankle rolls. Switch directions. Good, pitter patter those legs out. And then we're just gonna switch sides. You're gonna take the top of that left foot, exactly what we just did, to the outside of that hip. That foot is pointing straight back. Now, you're being pushed over to the right. Go ahead and place a block, blanket, whatever you got, underneath that right hip. You're trying to the best of your abilities to just allow yourself to relax, don't tense up. A little bit longer here. Go ahead. Gently bring it up, grabbing the top of that ankle, gently bringing that heel out in front, grabbing the bottom of that foot for a counter stretch of that ankle. Good, extending that leg out nice and long, pitter patter those legs out. Give some nice little ankle rolls going on here. Switch directions. Good. From here, I want you to roll it over onto your guys' bellies. I face you so you can see what I'm doing here. I want you to bring your right hand across, palm down. Now, this is already extremely deep stretch for the back of that right shoulder. Hang out here, or you can walk left hand all the way out to the right side, both palms completely down. Once again, if you have a block or a bolster or a blanket, pillow, whatever it may be, you can always let your forehead rest there, but we will be here for just a couple of minutes. just a little bit longer here. Very gently bring those hands next to the chest, tuck those elbows in real quick, and just let that forehead and your chin rest on your mat. Good, then we're gonna switch. So you're gonna bring that left arm across first, palm is down. And if that's already a deep stretch, hang out here. Try and keep those shoulders as squared off to the ground as you can. And then you're going to walk that right hand out to the left. You should primarily feel this in the left, back of the left shoulder. Very gently bringing those hands in next to the side again, tucking those elbows in, letting the forehead or chin rest on the ground. Good, now that we got the backs for the shoulders, let's get a little bit of the front and the pecs. Right hand is out to the side, palm down as always, straight up from that shoulder. And then as you roll it to the right, swing that left leg over. As you can see, my hand stays put. Do not let it slide down towards the back. I'm gonna open up that chest a little bit more if you'd like. You can take that left arm, swing around the low of the back. Is very gently roll it back onto your belly. Take your time here, no need to rush it. Bring that right hand in next to the side. Once again, tucking both those elbows in, just holding that chin rest on your mat. And then we're just gonna switch. So extending that left hand out to the side, palm down, straight up from that shoulder. Gonna roll it to the left, swinging that right leg over. Remember, you can hang out here, or take that right arm, swing it around below the back. Nice, slowly roll it back onto your belly. Bring both those hands in next to the chest again, tucking in those elbows, letting that chin or forehead rest on the mat. Nice, from here, press it all the way up in the cobra. Tucking those toes under, send those hips back in a downward facing dog. Go ahead and pedal out those feet. And from here, I'm going to bring right knee to right wrist for pigeon pose. Make sure those hips are squared off. The closer that foot is in, the easier, further out, the harder. As long as you have no knee pain, gently drop it down onto those forearms. Be here for a few minutes. gently bring it up onto those hands. You're done, bring it back in a downward facing dog. Maybe shake that leg, pedal out those feet. Right, bring left knee to left wrist, pigeon on the opposite side. Remember, keep those hips squared off. Closer that foot is in, the easier, further out the harder. If you have no knee bend, gently drop it down. Just a little longer here. Bring it up onto those hands. This time though, I want to bring that left leg back, knees as wide as the mat, toes together, sinking those hips all the way back to your heels, and then walk those hands out, just letting that forehead rest on the mat. And walking those hands all the way out to the left. For a little bit of a deeper stretch, you can place left hand on top of right. Think about dropping right shoulder, opening up that left rib cage up towards the ceiling. Good. Walk those hands all the way back to center. And then out to the right. This time for that deeper stretch, right hand on top of left. Think about dropping left shoulder, opening up rib cage. Good. I'm going to walk those hands back to center. And more than welcome to continue hanging out here or take your time, roll it over onto your back, coming into our final rest in Shavasana, bring it all the way down, letting those toes fall to the side, letting those hands rest by the side, letting that breath become shallow, letting the little things relax like your jaw, even the eyelids. slowly coming back to your breath. Adding small movements like wiggling the fingers and toes. Slightly larger, like rolling the wrists and ankles. Give yourself a nice stretch overhead, making yourself as long as possible from fingertips to toes. Rolling off to the side, using an arm as a pillow. Now you're ready, no rush. Slowly make your way back up into a seated position. Well, thanks for watching, guys. Hope you feel a little bit better. Until next time, namaste.